So the news came on Monday that the Holy Father is resigning. And it is a news that you have heard, and I have heard it on that Monday at least 100 times, because the telephone was ringing out of the hook, and it seemed that the people made responsible me for the resignation of the Holy Father. It was always a question, Father, why the Holy Father is resigning? I don't have anything to do with it. It was his decision and his free decision, and he can do it. And we have to see it a little in the perspective of the life of the Church. First, it is true that it did not happen for 600 years, but it is still contemplated in the Code of Canon Law, and there is that option for the Holy Father to resign. And so he used this option, and he did it as we have seen, with simplicity and humility. He said that he is not more strong enough to lead the Church, and so he decided to resign, and the cardinals will have to elect a new pope. So it is a new situation for us. In the past, we have seen the Pope die, and so naturally the replacement had to be found. Now there are so many questions for what will happen. Of course, this change of the change of the Holy Father makes a big feast for all kind of morons and specialists about the Church's life, who are now trying to find who will be the next pope and what will he change and how will he turn the Church upside down. So just to make it clear that the Church, the head of the Church is Jesus Christ himself. And the Jesus Christ is not changing. So the Church cannot change either. The Holy Father is the vicar of Christ. He's his representative, who in his name is leading the Church. And he knows, and he's very well aware of it, that the Lord will ask him quite seriously what he has done. And so he simply cannot do something wrong or something that would be against the will of the Lord. So he cannot change the Church, as Jesus is the same, he has to maintain that identity, and he has to be faithful to the truth that the Lord has left us here in the Holy Scripture and in his Church. Now, who will be the next pope? It is up to the cardinals to choose someone. The decision is always the decision of the gospel. So when the Lord was choosing Peter as his vicar, he was asking Peter not about studies, about money, about whom he knows. He was asking Peter, do you love me? Do you love me more than these? And that's the criteria of all times, and it will be criteria even this time. Now all those secondary questions, what can change or what will happen with the Holy Father? Nothing will happen, and the new Holy Father will come, will lead us as Pope Blessed John Paul II and Paul VI before him, and Pope Benedict. He will lead us again in truth and towards the Lord. Our own decision and our own concern must be only that we listen to him and follow what he is teaching. Now the announcement came as a kind of surprise, and we see that so many were even in a kind of shock. How could this happen? And we have to see it a little in the perspective that from the beginning, the Holy Father was not in some kind of excellent health. He was 78 years old when he was elected Pope, and it was clear that it was assumed that it will be for some short time, and he was there for 8 years. And he has done his best, at some point he simply cannot do more. What most people don't know, he had some light stroke long before he became Pope. Apparently it was healed. He has a pacemaker. All these things, one with the other, naturally limit him. And now he recognizes that he cannot lead the Church with enough strength anymore. And he was contemplating it for a long time. And in this interview with Peter Sewald in the book, The Light of the World, Peter Sewald was asking him about the resignation. And he said, yes, the resignation is possible, and yes, I could resign. But he said, I will never run away from the wolf, and I will never resign in the middle of some crisis, running away from my responsibility. And he added there very clearly that it must be done freely and in serenity. And it is exactly what the Holy Father has done. That he's not running from any responsibility of some trouble. He has just resigned in the moment when the church is apparently in good order, in at peace, in that atmosphere of serenity. And for us, it may sound that yes, it is lightning from the clear sky, but it is exactly how it should be. He resigns, not dumping some problems on someone else. No, he resigns when the things are okay. And he teaches us all that when we end the life, it should be in that serenity, in good order, and so that we pass the world, or our small world, that we pass it on others with in good shape, in peace, and in good order, in harmony. And so this last message of our Holy Father is really a challenge to all of us, that we use our life and end it in such a way that there is no mess left behind us, that we can go with a satisfaction of life lived well, the work well done, and that we leave to the others only gifts. May God bless you.